ஓரியன்டேஷன் ஃபார் நீட் ஆஸ்பைரன்ஸ் நீட் தேர்வு எழுதும் மாணவர்களுக்கான இது ஒரு வழிகாட்டி நிகழ்ச்சி. இன்றைய வகுப்பில் இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங் ஃபேக்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் மேஜர் ஃபைல் ஆஃப் அனிமல் கிங்டம் என்ற தலைப்பை நம்ம பார்க்க போகிறோம். பொதுவாகவே பயாலஜியில் ஒவ்வொரு தலைப்பிலையுமே இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங் ஃபேக்ட்ஸ் இருக்கும், அதெல்லாம் நம்ம தொகுத்து படிக்கணும். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், நம்ம அனிமல் கிங்டத்தில் தெர் ஆர் 10 ஃபைலம் இருக்குது. ஒவ்வொரு ஃபைலத்துலேயும் என்னென்ன இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங் ஃபேக்ட் இருக்குன்றதை நம்ம ஒன் பை ஒன்னாக பார்க்கலாம். ஃபஸ்ட்டு ஃபைலம் ஃபோரிஃபெரா. ஃபைலம் ஃபோரிஃபெராவில் யூப்ளக்டல்லா அப்படின்றது ஒரு டீப் சீ ஸ்பாஞ்சஸ்ஸு. இதனோட இதை காமனாக நம்ம வீனஸ் ஃப்ளவர் பேஸ்கெட்டுன்னு சொல்லுவோம். இந்த வீனஸ் ஃப்ளவர் பேஸ்கெட்டை ஜப்பானில் வெட்டிங் கிஃப்டாக கொடுக்குறாங்க. ஸோ யூப்ளக்டல்லா இஸ் எ ஜப்பானீஸ் வெட்டிங் கிஃப்ட் நோன் ஆஸ் த வீனஸ் ஃப்ளவர் பேஸ்கெட். This artifact is actually the skeleton of deep sea sponge. In traditional Asian culture, it was given as a wedding gift in its dead dry state because the sponge symbiotically houses two small shrimps, a male and a female, who live out their life inside the sponge. So it gives us a wedding gift. Then another interesting fact in phylum Porifera, totipotency. Totipotency cells. Archaeocytes are very important to the functioning of a sponge. These cells are totipotent, which means that they can change into all of the other types of spongy cells. That means archaeocytes can give rise to any kind of cells of the sponges. It may develop into coenocytes or porocytes or pinococytes or spicules, right? So archaeocytes ingest and digest food caught by the coenocyte collars and transport nutrients to other cells of the sponge. Now we come to the phylum Cnidaria. In the Cnidaria metagenesis, some Cnidarian exhibits the polyp and medusa forms. Such Cnidarian shows metagenesis. It is the phenomena of alternation of generation in which the polyp produce medusae asexually and medusae produce polyps sexually. So there is an alternation of generation, and this alternation of generation, what we call it as metagenesis. Then another interesting point is nematocyst, one of the stinging capsular organelle of the tentacle of Cnidarians, right? And usually it has a barbed venomous thread like structure which discharges especially for catching prey and defending against enemies. Simply we can call it as offense and defense. Then phylum Cnidaria. Phylum Cnidaria exhibit polymorphism. You know what is polymorphism? Polymorphism refers to the occurrence of structurally and functionally more than two different types of individuals within the same organism. It is the characteristic features of Cnidarians, particularly the polyps and medusa forms, are of zooids with the colonial organisms like those in Hydrozoa. Another interesting fact, Portuguese man of war. It gets name from the uppermost polyp, the gas-filled bladder, nematophore, which sits above the water and somewhat resembles an old warship at full sail. Man of wars, also known as blue bottles of the purple blue color of the nematophores. The tentacles are the man of war's second organisms. Another interesting fact in the phylum Cnidaria is commensalism. You know what is commensalism? It's a kind of animal association. It's a symbiotic relationship between anemone and clownfish. It's a classical example of two organisms benefiting each other. Symbiotic relationship is a relationship in which both the partners get benefited. The anemone provides clown with a protection and shelter, while the clownfish provides the sea anemone nutrients in the form of waste. Phylum Ctenophora. Phylum Ctenophora exhibit an interesting fact. You know what is the bioluminescence? The comb jellies protect themselves by giving off bioluminescent glow. They think it will scare any predators that might come their way. Just like the caveman used fire at night to keep the animals at bay, the jelly lights up at night when touched. So it is also an organ of, it's also used as offense and defense. Phylum Platyhelminthes. Phylum Platyhelminthes you know, this peculiar future, regeneration. Regeneration means regrowth of the lost parts. Planaria can be cut into pieces and each piece can regenerate into a complete organism. How it occurs? Cells at the locations of the wound site proliferate. Proliferate means multiply, to form a blastema that will differentiate into new tissues and regenerate the missing parts of the piece of the cut planaria. So it's an interesting fact seen in platyhelminthesis, especially in planaria. The next one is polyembryonic condition. Polyembryony is the phenomena two or more embryos developing from a single fertilized egg. For example, in Fasciola hepatica exhibits this phenomena of polyembryony. Fasciola eggs develops into Myrasidium larvae, and these Myrasidium larvae enters into the body of the digestive glands of snail, where it develops into sporocyst. This sporocyst gives rise to radiae, and finally the radial larva develops into Cercaria larva and Metacercaria. At this level, it settles at the bottom of the aquatic plants, and when the sheep grass, when the sheep grazing the aquatic vegetation, that Metacercaria larva get into the alimentary canal of the sheep. Phylum Platyhelminthesis. Phylum Platyhelminthesis exhibit parasitic adaptations. The parasitic adaptations are morphological adaptations and physiological adaptation. First, we will see morphological adaptations. One is locomotory organs are reduced. Since they are parasites, there is no need to move from one place to another. So, locomotory organs are reduced. And second one, since it is parasite, alimentary canal is absent in tinea solium. Since the tinea simply absorbs the food through the general body surface from the host, and the presence of thick cuticle is another peculiar parasitic adaptation, which protects the parasite from the host enzymes. Then apparatus of attachment like hooks and suckers well developed. Then physiological adaptations like respiration in anaerobic. You know, since it is parasitic, they respire without oxygen, anaerobic mode of respiration, and they secrete anti-enzymes which act against the enzymes produced by the host, and then reduction of pathogenicity. So, this is very interesting. Phylum Platyhelminthesis, cephalization. The members of the phylum Platyhelminthesis are organized with the brain and the sense organs at the front of the animal. This is called cephalization. In animals with the cephalization, the sense organs are comes in contact with the environment first. Then measly fork. The measly fork is the flesh of pig, which consists of many fork worms called measly tapeworm, Stenia solium. And this tapeworm infects the flesh of the pig and make it poisonous. Phylum Achelminthesis exhibits cuticle. Cuticle is the body covered by transparent and tough and protective collagenous layer called cuticle, which protects the parasite from the host enzyme action. Phylum Annelida. Phylum Annelida exhibit an interesting one, hydroskeleton. The earthworm does not contain any bone, skeleton or cartilage. They have hydrostatic skeleton, which consists of fluid-filled cavity, the coelom, surrounded by muscles. The pressure of the fluid and the action of the surrounding circular muscles are used to create the shape of the worm and prevent the worm from collapsing on itself. This shape changes whenever it swims, burrows and itself underground. Phylum Annelida. Thiflosole. In earthworm, it is a dorsal flap of the intestine that runs along most of its length. Its function is to increase the surface area of the intestine for more efficient absorption of digested nutrients. Phylum Annelida also exhibit another interesting fact, botryoidal tissues. In leeches, you know, leech is a sanguivorous animal, blood sucking animals. In that, the botryoidal tissue is a special kind of tissue, occupies the body cavity between the gut and the body wall. Its function is excretion. Then The same leech also exhibit another interesting fact, anticoagulant. Leeches produce an enzyme in their saliva called hirudin. This hirudin is a powerful anticoagulant. This anticoagulant prevent the host from forming a clot so that they can feast on blood more easily. Phylum Arthropoda. Phylum Arthropoda, which mainly includes insects, which shows variety of mouth parts. First, biting and chewing type. This type of mouth parts is found in grasshoppers and cricket. And the siphoning type of mouth parts, especially in butterfly and moth, they are having a coiled tube-like structure with the help of which it collects the nectars from the flower, siphoning type. And the piercing and the sucking type of mouth parts is found in mosquito, right? Mosquito and bugs. And the lapping and the chewing type of mouth parts is found in honeybees. And sponging and the sucking type of mouth parts is found in housefly. Phylum Arthropoda. Economic importance. Apiculture. The scientific method of beekeeping of get the honey is termed as apiculture. Apis dorsata, Apis mellifera, Apis florea, Apis indica. These are all different species among the honeybees, right? Then sericulture, the breeding and the management of silkworm for the production of silk is termed as sericulture. Bombyx mori, eri, muga, these are all different species of silkworm. Then lac culture. Lac is the resinous secretion of the tiny lac insect lacifer. Then gregarious pest, locusta, locust. You know, nowadays it's very common, which causes major damages to the crops, gregarious pest. Then phylum Arthropoda. In the phylum Arthropoda, especially in case of honeybees, exhibit nuptial flight. Nuptial flight is the mating flight of some insects, most notably social bees and ants. Winged sexuals are produced within the colony. Then waggle dance of honeybee. The waggle dance is a special figure of eight dance that is done by the honeybee in its hive. By this, the worker tells others where it has found the nectar. It's very often this question will appears. Okay, next. Phylum Arthropoda. Ecdysis molting. In arthropods such as insects, arachnids, crustaceans, molting is the shedding of the exoskeleton or is shedding of the skin, typically to let the organism grow. This process is called ecdysis, which is carried out by a hormone called ecdysone. And then another interesting fact, you know, metamorphosis. When immature insects and the adult have different forms, the process called complete metamorphosis. Metamorphosis in the sense that gradual development. For example, you take complete metamorphosis seen in butterfly, where the egg develops into larva, the larva develops into pupae, and pupae develops into adult. So here the development is gradual, such and also complete. That's why it is called complete metamorphosis. Example, butterfly. An incomplete metamorphosis, where the egg gives rise to a nymph and the nymph develops into adult. So here there is no larval form. That's why it is called incomplete metamorphosis. And this type of metamorphosis seen in cockroaches. Phylum Arthropoda. Another interesting fact in the phylum Arthropoda is the compound eyes. Compound eyes of cockroach are large, black, kidney shaped. It is dorsoventrally on the head. Each eye consists of nearly 1000 to 2000 small units called omatidium, each capable of forming an image. Such type of image is called a mosaic image. The eyes are covered externally with a transparent cuticle called cornea. So this is the structure of compound eye. You can see the different parts of the compound eye. Parthenogenesis. In honeybees colonies, the fertilized eggs becomes female and the unfertilized eggs will develop into male drones. This is a process known as haplodiploid mechanism or haploid parthenogenesis. The unfertilized egg has only half the number of chromosomes of a fertilized egg. These eggs are not fertilized and will produce only male honeybees. We will see in the next diagram. Okay, here you can see the haploid diploid sex determination system. Here you know this female or diploid, and here you can see 32 number of chromosomes. Whereas in male, it is haploid having half the number of chromosomes, 16. In female, meiosis takes place. Meiosis is a reduction division where the chromosome number is reduced into half. So, two eggs are produced. Then one haploid egg, where at the same time in case of male, the chromosome number is 16, it undergo mitosis, right? And as a result, the chromosome number is the same without any reduction. When the haploid egg is fertilized by a haploid sperm, as a result of fertilization, a 2N diploid female is formed. Whereas the other egg without fertilization develops into a male, then usually drones. So this type of fertilization is called parthenogenesis. Parthenogenesis, where the haploid egg develops into male without fertilization. This type of sex determination is called haploid diploid method of sex determination, is found in honeybees. Phylum Arthropoda, connecting links. It's a very interesting term, connecting link. For example, Peripatus. Peripatus is a primitive arthropod having jointed paired legs and compound eyes and tracheal tubes like other arthropods, but it also displays certain annelidan character such as worm like see, when you observe the diagram, you can see the segmented body, non-chitinous cuticle and segmented nephridia. These are all annelidan character. So since the animal exhibit both the arthropod as well as annelidan character, it forms a connecting link between annelida and arthropoda. Another interesting fact, you know, living fossil. You know what is living fossil? For example, you take Limulus. Limulus is also called the king crab or horseshoe crab. They are continuous to remain unchanged for the past 190 million years, and it is therefore also called as living fossils. Then phylum Mollusca, devilfish. Octopus is also known as devilfish. It bears the name, it's due to the appearance of 8 muscular arms or tentacles. You can see it gives an appearance of a devil, and that's why it is called a devil fish. Octopus is also known as devil fish. Then especially molluscan forms like squid and octopus, they have an ink gland. See, usually they dwell in the light conditions and have an ink sac, which can be used to expel a cloud of dark ink in order to confuse the predator. Whenever they come across the predator, they simply eject the ink into the medium which threaten the enemies. At the same time, it also escapes from the enemies, right? So ink gland. Then smoke screen. In case of octopus, use their ink to create a smoke screen to allow them to escape from situations. The ink may also impact the predator's sense of sight. Phylum Mollusca, tarsion. Tarsion allows foot to be retracted after the head for better protection of head. Detarsion is the reversal of tarsion, which takes place when during evolution the shell is lost. A type of shell evolves that has opening on the opposite sides. In such a way, situation, twisting of visceral mass is unnecessary. Connecting link. The organism which possess the characters of two different groups are called connecting links. Phylum Mollusca. In phylum Mollusca, the connecting link between annelida and mollusca is neoplina. It has a trochophore larva like annelida. It has shell and mantle similar to mollusca. It shows the presence of flat muscular foot like mollusca. Since it shows both characters of both annelid as well as mollusk, it is considered as a connecting link, right? between annelida and mollusca. Right. Another interesting fact in mollusca, pearl formation. Pearls are formed inside the shell of certain mollusks as a defensive mechanism against potentially threatening irritants such as parasite inside the shell, or it may be a small dust particle or a sand particle. Whenever this dust particle or sand particle or any irritant substance which enter into the mantle, and immediately the mantle secretes a substance called aragonite and concholine is called a nacre, which makes up the mother of pearl. You know, see the different stages how the pearls are formed in the diagram, and you can see the outer layer and inner nacreous and inner the irritant, or namely the it may be a dust particle or a sand particle. Phylum Echinodermata. Regeneration and autotomy. You know, regeneration is also seen in phylum Platyhelminthes, but here regeneration accompanied with autotomy. Autotomy refers to an adaptive detachment of animal body parts where this severs a defense function, is achieved by an intrinsic mechanism and is nervously mediated. Most echinoderms, a regeneration is therefore necessitated by autotomy and proceeds from the retained side of the fractured autotomy plane. Simply you can say, whenever that starfish met in a danger, immediately they detach their arms to escape from the enemies, and that is called autotomy, self-cutting, and then the last parts are regenerated, that is called regeneration. Another interesting fact in phylum Echinodermata is water vascular system. You know, my dear student, you might have studied about water canal system in case of porifera, but water vascular system, which is a peculiar feature seen in Echinodermata, see here the way how the water enters into different parts of the body. Like first of all madreporite, and then madreporite and followed by stone canal, and the stone canal is followed by ampulocral radial canal, and then ampulocral ring canal, and Tiedemann's body and Pollein vesicles, lateral canal and tube feet. So this is what we call it as water vascular system, which is a peculiar feature, is found in the phylum Echinodermata. Phylum Hemichordata. Ciliary feeder. These organisms are filter feeders using their cilia to create current to direct the food. Their tentacle also flicks the food into the food canal. And another interesting one, Trichoderma flava, is an Indian hemichordate found in Crocodile Islands in Tamil Nadu. Now we come to that self-evaluation of the interesting facts of major phyla of animal kingdom. The first question is, in sponges, totipotent cells are? Answer, archaeocytes. You know what is totipotency? A cell has the ability to develop into any kind of cells. Archaeocytes are totipotent cells of sponges. Metagenesis, you know, my dear student, metagenesis otherwise called alternation of generation. So the answer is alternation of generation between asexual and the sexual basis of organisms in case of coelenterates. Planaria possess high capacity, you know that planarians possess high capacity of regeneration, the power of regrowth of the lost parts, regeneration. Right, whereas metamorphosis seen in arthropods like butterfly, alternation of generation is seen in animals, whereas you know coelenterates, and bioluminescence in Ctenophora, whereas planaria possess the high capacity of regeneration. You know that in interesting question, measly pork. What is measly pork? Which contains cysticercus or bladder worm in their flesh of pork. Right, that is called a cysticercus. Answer is cysticercus or bladder worm, which is not a typical character of phylum Achelminthes. Achelminthes possess syncytial epidermis, okay, correct. Non-living cuticle, correct. Pseudocoelomate, correct. All are parasites in this animal group. This is the answer. This is not the character of the phylum Achelminthes. Some of them are free livings, right? So here what is given, all are parasites in these animal groups. That is the wrong answer. The, okay. Which of the following feature is not present in the earthworm? Typhlosole increase the absorptive surface of the intestine. Yes, it's a, is present in, it's a character of in, earthworm. Earthworm moves with the help of setae, muscles and hydrostatic skeleton. Yes, it is also true. It possesses anticoagulant iridin, that is absent. You know, iridin is found in leeches, which possess an anticoagulant, thereby it prevents the coagulation of blood. It's not the features of earthworm. Whereas the blood vascular system is closed type, that is also found in earthworm. So answer is C. It possesses an anticoagulant iridin. Piercing and sucking mouth parts occurs in. You know, the answer is mosquito. You know, mosquito which pierces the needle and sucks the blood. So piercing and sucking type of mouth parts is occurs in mosquito. In case of butterfly, you know, siphoning type. In case of housefly, you know, sponging type. In case of cockroach, it is biting and chewing type. So the answer for the seventh question is mosquito, D option. Neoplina. Neoplina is a connecting link between mollusca and annelida. Neoplina is the connecting link between mollusca and annelida. Like annelida, it has a trochophore larva. Like mollusk, it has a shell and a muscular foot. Right? You know very well the reptiles and birds, archaeopteryx. Archaeopteryx is the connecting link between reptiles and birds. And you know, peripatus is the connecting link between annelida and arthropoda. Whereas neoplina is the connecting link between mollusca and annelida. Answer C. Just now we studied that water vascular system is found in. Water vascular system is found in. Answer echinodermata. Option B. You know, echinodermata. Whereas in case of porifera, it is called a water canal system. Water vascular system is found in echinodermata, which is a peculiar feature of phylum echinodermata. Then important characteristics that hemichordate share with the chordate is, very good, pharynx with the gill slits. Like a chordate, this hemichordate, namely the balanoglossus, commonly called a tongue worm, possess gill slits at the pharynx, which is also, this structure is also found in chordate character. Chordate, that's the answer. Answer B, pharynx with the gill slits. Nama interesting facts of major phylum animal kingdom. Kuripa biology la neenga endha oru thalaippu eduthinaalum adha interesting fact irukum adhu nammalku unmaiyile vande nammudaiya aarvathai thoondum adanalada ellarume solluvanga neenga neat exam la first biology part eduth answer pannunga solitte kuripa nammalala idha mari interesting fact easy ah nyabam vechirukka mudiyum maanavargale neenga endha thalaippu thayar seidhalum adhu sambandhama neenga notes thayar pannalum ஒவ்வொரு தலைப்புக்குமே இன்ட்ரெஸ்டிங் ஃபேக்ட்ஸ் என்பதை என்னென்ன லிஸ்ட் பண்ணி வச்சுங்க அதை எக்ஸாமுக்கு முன்னால் திருப்பி பாருங்கள் அது உங்களுக்கு மிகவும் உதவும் தேங்க்யூ